So some of the stuff we wanted to talk about is part of the story of how we got this thing to work the way it does, some of the problems we face and still have because this thing is really fragile and breaks all the time for different reasons, and all the things students have to be able to do to be able to constantly redesign it, fix it, change it, improve it, and all of that. Because even though this thing was designed and built in about 6.5 weeks, the actual construction of this machine and all of its parts was about 2 weeks of time. So this thing was designed in under a month, like come up with all the ideas, and then actually assembled in only a couple of weeks. And once it was assembled, it was a ton of redesign constantly. So things to look for, there are motors on this thing all over. There are wires going to those motors. There are sensors that are detecting things. There are actual mechanical things like these ropes here that help lift. They have the metal frame. We have our drivetrain that has chains driving between motors. There's gearboxes around those motors. We have this electronics board. We want to give a nice little 180. We have our electronics board and a battery in the back. We have a wireless router that connects to our computer so we can send it messages. There's air tanks on board that provide power for shifting, because this thing can shift from low to high gear. A whole bunch of stuff. Cameras on board that you can see up there from the driver's station, so you can line up with stuff. There's a lot of elements to this, and this is by far our most complicated robot that we've ever built at Byron High School robotics team. And what we want you to do is get a chance to get in here, start asking questions about this machine, but also, like,